happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Karev Farms here with another video, and today we are back on Belgique Profonde. Just finished recording the first episode and just finished raking the field. So in this episode, we are going to get the 1570 and New Holland Roll Belt 450 out, and we are going to go bale all of the hay in that field. So let's get going. We're going to open up our door and our door and windows, get some air through here. I'm going to bring up the HUD and I'm going to turn the map off. There we go. So I'm going to do most of this from in cab, but we need to get this guy unfolded, get him dropped down. Okay, why are you being so laggy? Okay, whoa, what the heck? It's this baler, I think. Doesn't like it. That's messed up. Okay, well, I was hoping to use this baler, but I guess it looks like we're gonna have to sell that one and use the in-game one, which kind of sucks. I don't know what what the deal is with that one. So I guess we will use this one. And we're just going to reset it. Just not waste time. Well, that really sucks. I don't know why it's doing that either. So I guess we'll unfold it. So we lost a little bit of hay, but hopefully it shouldn't make too much of a difference. Okay, so now hopefully this baler will work. Yep. Okay. Okay, so I need to set a cruise control for, we'll go 7. I guess I can go out of cab for some of it, and then some of it I'll go in cab on. So what we'll do is these end rows, the headland rows, will go out of cab, and then on the straighter rows will go. So yeah, that's gonna roll. That kinda sucks. Oh well. I need to remember to take a screenshot, because the whole time I was raking, I didn't even take a single screenshot. Which kind of sucks. So yes, I am swerving. Because that's how we bail. Well, that's how most people bail, really, because it, you know, it gets an even feed. I guess we can go in cab now. So yeah, I guess I don't really have much to talk about in this video because I just finished recording one. But I just yesterday bought Construction Simulator 2016. I bought the Gold Edition. And so I started playing that a lot yesterday. So if you guys want to see some videos on that, let me know. I could make it a possibility. I just want to make sure that this bail ain't going to roll into the water. I could make that a possibility of maybe doing some construction sim. I have to make I have to test it here later and make sure that, you know, when I have my my headset plugged in, that the audio will go through the headset and stuff, because with like American Truck Simulator, I had an issue where the audio will not go through my headset. So when I plug my headset in, it keeps going through my computer. Therefore, it won't allow me to, like when I try and record, I'm jackknifing. When I try and record, it won't, you know, like there's no game sound. So I don't know what the issue is there. So I'm hoping Construction Simulator won't do the same thing for me. I don't think it's just my headset, because I had bought another one thinking that it was going to be a good one, but it wasn't. It was kind of a waste of money. And when I had used it, I tried it with American Truck, I think, and I'm pretty sure it did the same thing. So that kind of sucks, but really, I honestly haven't even touched American Truck Sim in forever, because I just haven't really felt like playing it. I've just done more farm sim and modding and stuff than anything, so just kind of been sticking to that. And so I doubt that I'm going to actually be able to turn around here, so I'm just going to back it up. See, I had thought about using the John Deere 864 Premium. Oops, I'm jackknifing again. I had thought about using the 864 Premium baler, but it doesn't really go with, you know, some of the other equipment I'm using. It's kind of more newer and larger than most of the stuff I'm using. So I decided not to use it. Now we can go in cab, I guess. So how many bales have we gotten so far? We've gotten 7 so far, and we're making an 8th. So I don't think that I even actually set my timer, did I? No. So I think this episode I'll just kind of try and bale the whole field, I guess. And then we'll see how that goes. We'll see how long it gets, I guess, and go from there. So yeah, see if we can make this corner. No, we're not going to make it. I thought I would, but guess not. There we go. Maybe this one I can make. Yep, there we go. That one worked like it was supposed to. So we're gonna back up here a little bit. I'm gonna try not to jackknife again. There we go. And then we got another bale. It looks like we are going to have a fair amount of bales. I don't know how long they'll last, but yes, if we need more hay before this field is fully grown again, we can always cut some other fields. So we're just going to whip around here and pick up this windrow. It all up. Ah, good enough. Yeah, sorry that I'm not talking a whole lot, I guess. I don't know what to talk about. It's the only bad thing about recording more than one video at a time is that kind of don't have anything to talk about. We talk about everything in the first video, and then you got another half-hour video, and you don't know what the heck to talk about. Pick up this windrow here. And then we'll unload again. Now we're at 14 bales, so not bad. Lift the pickup, and then we'll go over here to this windrow. And this will take us all the way around again, I think. Or should. Alright. Now we're at 15. yeah, I think we'll get a good amount of hay off of this. Once we are done with everything on this field, I'll have to put some NPK down on it. Get it, let's just check. Yeah, we got 4-2, so I think we could boost that a little bit. Put a shot of NPK down. And then we can make that a little bit nicer. Let's lift the pickup again and run over here. I believe, yes, we have two little windrows over here that we can pick up. Just about got all of that. Okay, we'll pick up this little strip here and then lift the pickup. And then we'll go and go to the far edge and work our way in. Now we can go in cab again. So yeah, this is probably one of my more favorite things to do is hay, just because that's what we do, so more used to doing hay, I guess. The only bad thing about my Will Brothers Farms map that I'm making is that it's all grain, but I am thinking of setting up. Because there's so many waterways and stuff, normally they have a neighbor that comes and he cuts it and then he bales it and uses the hay for his cattle. So what I'm thinking about doing is I'll set up a bunch of racket going on outside. Set up one of the farms. There's one farm that has like a big haystack by it. In Google Earth anyways. So what I might do is set up that farm to have like a bale sell point. So then what you can do, then, you know, what I'll be able to do is make hay from the waterways and then use that as a means to get a little more cash. So that would be kind of a neat idea. I was tossing that back and forth because then if I did that, then I'd also be able to make hay with some of this hay equipment that I want to make. I want to make a lot of our equipment that we use. So it'd be a way to be able to use that. So I think that's, you know, it's probably what I might end up doing. Let's fill the baler again. So now we're at 19. So this tractor is mainly going to be a baling tractor. This tractor, the Model A, and the Farmall 300 are pretty much, you know, the Model A is going to run the sickle mower, 300 is going to run the rake, and then this is going to run the baler. That's kind of how it's going to be set up. Just because, you know, I wanted to use that equipment just because it's kind of neater, but then I couldn't run baler with those things because they're way too underpowered to run, you know, even this baler. And I didn't want to use the little square baler that came with the small farming pack because I really don't like doing square bales a lot. The little teeny ones anyways, when they're the larger ones, you know, that come out of like the in-game square baler and that kind of stuff, those ones I don't mind when they're larger, but those teeny tiny ones like that, those are just, they're worthless. because you can't really stack them because they're so small and they're just very difficult to do in general. So yeah, we should have about, I'm going to guess about 30 bales off of this field, which isn't too bad. It's a fairly decent sized field, actually. But I think if we give it a shot of MPK over it and let that sink in, I think we might actually get a better yield next season or the next cutting. Just because it'll have a little better nutrients. Maybe I'll run over it with the Mandaco as well and add a little bit of moisture to it. We'll see, I guess. See what happens. Once we finish the hay, we'll do harvesting though. Then we can get some straw and stuff. We are actually going to have to cut some more hay. I didn't think about that. Or maybe we can do it. I have to look. Maybe you can make silage from straw as well. Because if we can do that, then we can just use some of our barley and wheat for that. Because I do own every single field. I think I took out like a $5 million loan. Or maybe I didn't take out a loan. Maybe I just kind of cheated in the money. I don't remember anymore. But, as you can see, we have almost $4.2 million right now, so. But, yeah, I don't know. Let's look. Edit loan. Yep, we have a $6 million loan. So, I did take out a lot of loan, so we'll have to pay that back over time. I don't remember if this map has any multi-fruits or not. I guess it's kind of worthless to look here because... Oh, maybe not. So I think it just has oats. Yeah, just oats. Wow, pigs and beef have a good price. Dang. So yeah, it looks like our only... multi-fruit crop is oats, which is a reasonably good crop, I guess. I don't mind doing that one. Oh, geez, we're going to hit the fence. I kind of messed up in my turning on that one. Well, maybe we're going to have about 25 bales then. It doesn't look like we're going to get 30. Oh, well, it'll last us for a while, I guess. We can just go make 25 straw bales, and then, or 26, however many hay bales we get, we can make that same amount in straw, and then the rest of our straw we'll use to fill our silage pits, if you can use straw. I'm going to do a test with that. When I start cutting, I'll get the forage wagon out and just pick up a very tiny bit and see if I can actually dump it into the silage area. I believe that you can, but I just don't remember offhand. All right, and that is all of the baling. So we will fold our baler up. And, so that's going to do it for this episode. I'm actually not entirely sure of how long this episode ended up being. I will look here in just a moment. So what I'm going to do is... Let me just look here. Oh, 25 minutes. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to wash this stuff and get it all parked. And then... the next episode, we will be hauling the bales. I think this is washing. Yep, I think so. Okay, that's all cleaned up. We'll wash off the rake now. Come on, rake clean. You see, there's a little bit of dirt right there. That's good enough, I guess. Now we'll wash this guy off. Oh, I was thinking that was dirt down there, but wasn't. And I don't know if the Model A actually has dirt on it. Doesn't look like it, no. So now we'll wash off our baler and 1570. And there is a little bit of hay in there, which isn't realistic to do, but once we start baling straw, it'll change over. I know that's not realistic to do either, but work with what you got, I guess. It is just a game. Ah, that's right. I need to bump this thing up to the fourth gear. Let's back this guy in. Let's see if I can do it. The first time I backed it in here, I kind of screwed it up. There we go. That worked pretty well. Now we'll back this guy back into the shed. This is actually like a chicken coop, but I'm not using chickens, so as you can see right here, here's where you go and collect the eggs. And then the chickens kind of roam around in here and roam around out in this pen and out in the yard and whatnot. There we go. Wasn't moving at first. Alright, so then this guy will get backed in right next to the mower. If I can get it. There we go. Perfect. Now we'll back this guy in front of Model A. Just like that. Oh, you get off the back. Okay. Did not know that. And then we'll hop into the 1570 here. And we'll back this guy into the shed as well. We're going to close all of our doors and windows. And we'll get back on in there. Actually, we're going to open our back window for now. Just while we back in. Although it actually really doesn't make much of a difference, so. Yep, I got to pull out and redo. Redo it. I'm getting a little off on that. There we go. Perfect. Alright, guys, that's going to do it for this episode. In the next episode, we will haul all of our bales and stack them. In the meantime, I'm going to figure out where the heck I'm going to stack them. Let's just look. I can't really stack them there. What the heck was that? He just, like, climbed right over that. What in the world? I don't think there's any place in here that we could stack them. No. Let's hop into this truck once. Yeah, there's really nowhere good to stack them. We could stack them down here. Maybe that's even what I was even planning. I don't know. We can stack them down in this shed is what we can do with them. So, I don't know. Even better. Here we go. We can stack them down here. So I guess we will make this be our marker. So on one side will be hay and one side will be straw. So, all right, guys. That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoy previous videos and to see future videos. Don't forget to check out down below in the description for links to my social media, mod site, and other cool YouTube channels to check out. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next.